Good morning, grade A students. In this session, we're going to continue with our chapter digestion, part 5, and we'll continue to talk about enzymes. Enzymes, we said that they are the biological scissors that cut, that break down, that digest, that hydrolyze, that break down food into smaller pieces. These enzymes, they are cut without any consumption. They stay the same till the end of the reaction. So we said that we have different types of medium. We have the neutral medium, we have the acidic medium, and we have the basic. We said that the neutral, where the pH is approximately 7, it's around 7, so it's approximately 7, while the acidic medium, the pH, it's less than 7, so it's 5, 4, 3, 2, or 1, and the basic, where the pH, it's greater than 7. So it's greater than 7, so it's a basic medium. Now, let's continue to talk about the enzymes. As I said, they are all the biological scissors that cut, digest, and break down food into smaller pieces. All the juices, they contain enzymes, except for the bile. It doesn't contain an enzyme. And this is special about the bile. Here, we continue with this table. This table, we started in this table. We took that inside our mouth. We have a special gland that's called salivary gland. What does it create? It creates a juice. It's called saliva. This juice contains an enzyme. It's called salivary amylase. So salivary amylase, it works on the starch and only works on the starch. It can't work on a substance other than the starch. So it works only on the starch to give the product, which is the maltose, the type of sugar, which is glucose and glucose. Neutral medium, it's pH equals 7, and the temperature is always 37, which is the body temperature. Then we move to the stomach. We talk about the stomach because that we have in the stomach, we have a special gland. This gland, we call it the gastric gland. This gastric gland, it secretes a special juice. This juice is called the gastric juice. This juice is called a gastric juice where it contains the enzyme pepsin. So start with the letter P. That works on protein, start with the letter P, to give peptide, that start with the letter P. So pepsin, it works on protein to give peptide. And the medium is acidic, meaning that the pH is less than 7. And always, temperature 37, since it's the normal body temperature. And here you can know, remember the three P's, pepsin, protein, peptide. Pepsin, it's similar to the Pepsi, so it's acidic. So pepsin works in acidic medium. Moving now to the small intestine. In the small intestine, we have the gland, which is called the pancreas. The pancreas secretes a special juice, which is called the pancreatic juice. The pancreatic juice, it contains enzymes called peptidase. So every word that ends with the ase, it's an enzyme. Peptidase, it works on peptides to give what? To give amino acid. So peptide is the intermediate form of protein. You notice here, all the lessons or all the sessions, they are related to each other. First, we started about the different types of food, the carbohydrates, complex, simplest, intermediate, proteins, complex, simplest, intermediate form, and also about the lipids, the complex and the simplest, we don't have intermediate. So here peptide is the intermediate form of the protein. Whenever it's digested, it gives the amino acid, where the medium is basic. So here the pH, it's greater than 7, and the temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. It's the normal body temperature. Moving now to the other enzyme that's found in the pancreatic juice. Also pancreas, it secretes a pancreatic juice that contains the enzyme trypsin. So trypsin, it works on protein to give what? To give amino acid, where the medium is basic. So the pH is also greater than 7. And temperature is the 37 degrees Celsius. It's the normal body temperature. And all of the enzymes inside our body, they work at 37. If the temperature is not 37, these enzymes will not work at all, or they have deficiency, or they have a problem in their work. So here, you have to keep it in mind. The temperature and the pH, they are specific for every enzyme. For example, here in trypsin, it works in basic medium. So if I put it in an acidic medium, it won't work. This enzyme becomes non-functional. It won't work unless in basic. And it won't work unless the temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. Moving now to the pancreas, also secretes pancreatic juice that contains the enzyme amylase. The enzyme amylase, wait a minute, we heard about this. This is the amylase, but here it's salivary amylase. Here it's only amylase. So it works on starch, similar to the salivary amylase that works on starch. To give maltose also, here it gives maltose. Here the medium is in neutral for the salivary amylase, while for the amylase, the medium is basic. So the temperature is 37 degrees Celsius as well. Moving also for the pancreas, it secretes another juice. It's called pancreatic juice. So the pancreatic juice contains an enzyme called lipase. Lipase, it works on lipids. So it works on lipids to give what? To give fatty acids and glycerol. From its name, lipase. So here, ase, enzyme, lipase, lipids. So it works on lipids to give fatty acids and glycerol. The medium here is basic. The temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. As you notice here, all of them at the level of the small intestine, all of the medium is basic, while only in the stomach it's acidic and the mouth it is neutral, while the rest, all of them, they are basic. Moving now for the liver. The liver secretes a special juice. It's called bile. And we said that we have something special about bile, that it doesn't contain any enzyme. But bile, it works on the lipids. It leads to the emulsification of lipids. So it gives emulsified lipids. The medium here, it's basic. So the pH, it's greater than 7, and the temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. So now we'll move to the new enzymes and the new ideas in this session. So small intestine also, we have the intestinal glands, what do they secrete? Intestinal glands, they secrete intestinal juice. So intestinal juice, it contains a special enzyme called secretase. Secretase, as of the word ase, so it works on sucrose. Sucrose, as you know, as we studied before, is composed from glucose and fructose. So it digests sucrose into glucose and fructose. The medium is basic, but the pH, it's greater than 7, and the temperature is 37 degrees Celsius, usually. So here, sucrase, from its name, sucrase, sucrose. So it works on sucrose to give, what is the sucrose composed of? Glucose and fructose. The medium is basic, temperature 37 degrees Celsius. Moving now to the trigger. This is the enzyme sucrase. Sucrase works with the enzyme. It works on sucrose to give glucose and fructose. The medium is basic. Moving now to the second enzyme. Second enzyme is called the maltase. Also the intestinal glands, they secrete intestinal juice. Inside this juice, what do we have? Inside the intestinal juice, we have the enzyme maltase. So maltase, it works on what? It works on maltose. As its name indicates, maltase, maltose. So maltase, it works on maltose. So what is the maltose? It's glucose and glucose. Remember these notes, we studied them before. So these lessons, they are related to each other. If you didn't study before, this you have problem in studying or in identifying the product. If you know that maltose, it's glucose and the glucose, so whenever we have maltase, what is the product? It's going to be glucose and glucose. Medium is basic and the temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. So here, and now we have two new enzymes. So let's make a quick revision for these two. Intestinal glands, they secrete a juice. What do we call this juice? Intestinal juice. And this juice, we have enzyme secretase that works on sucrose to give glucose and fructose. Medium is basic, temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. Now we move to the intestinal glands that contains the intestinal juice as well, contains the enzyme maltase. Maltase, it works on maltose to give glucose and the glucose as a product. The medium is basic and the temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. Moving for a new enzyme. Also, we still in the intestinal glands. Maltose, we have by the action of the enzyme maltase, it gives glucose and the glucose. Since maltose, two glucose molecules. And maltose, an example about the disaccharides. Also, intestinal glands, what do they secrete? Intestinal glands, they secrete intestinal juice. In this intestinal juice, we have an enzyme lactase. Lactase, it ends with the A's. So it's an enzyme. Lactase, it works on what? On lactose. To give what? To give glucose and galactose. Since lactose is composed of glucose and galactose. And the medium is basic. Temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. So here you have to pay attention. Already we studied that sucrose, it's a glucose and the fructose. Already we studied that maltose, it's a glucose and the glucose. Already we studied that lactose, it's a glucose and galactose. The medium is basic in all of this. Why? Because they work in a pH greater than 7. And all of them, they work in a temperature 37 degrees Celsius, since it's the normal body temperature. So here, all the notes you have to know about this. It's very simple. Sucrase, sucrose. Lactase works on lactose. Maltase works on maltose. So all of them, they are related. So whenever you hear the word sucrase, it works on sucrose. Maltase, it works on maltose. Whenever you heard the word lactase, it works on lactose. So also, you studied that sucrose is composed of glucose and fructose. Maltose is glucose and glucose. And lactose, the glucose, and galactose. All of them, they are two sugars. So whenever we say two sugars, this is the intermediate form of the carbohydrate. What do we call it by? Disaccharide. Di, two sugars bonded together. So here, we talk about the lactose. So here, lactose, by the action of the enzyme lactase, it gives the glucose and galactose. Here, the medium is basic, and we have temperature 37 degrees Celsius. As you notice here, all of these, they have glucose in common. So if you notice here, all of them, they have glucose in common. Here we have glucose. Glucose and the glucose. So all of them, they contain the glucose. But the second one, so sucrose, it's a glucose and fructose. This is a special. Maltose, it's a glucose and glucose. While lactose, it's a glucose and galactose. Medium, all of them, it's basic. Temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. Moving now to the last enzyme. The last enzyme is also found at the level of the small intestine, in the intestinal gland, that secretes the intestinal juice that contains the enzyme lipase. Lipase, also it works on what? It works on lipids. So lipids, they give what? They give fatty acid and glycerol. The medium is basic and the temperature is 37 degrees Celsius as well. Wait a minute, we have before an enzyme lipase, but it's the level of the pancreas, okay? So we have two enzymes lipase, one of them at the level of the pancreas, as you see here, this is the enzyme lipase. So here we have this enzyme, this is the lipase at the level of the pancreas, and also we have an enzyme lipase that's at the level of the small intestine. So here you have to know that lipase that broke down small fats. So here we need the action of the bile. Without the bile, the digestion of lipids will be a big problem and will be harder and harder for the lipase enzyme. So we have to have the bile, because bile has a role in emulsification of the lipids. So what does it do? It emulsifies the lipids. It separates the lipids molecules so they become smaller in size, as we said before, and then lipase comes to break down these small fats into fatty acids and glycerol, where the medium should be basic and temperature should be 37 degrees Celsius. So as a conclusion for all these enzymes, they are very important, and we have to review them and as well to study them. You have to know that in the mouth, we have salivary gland. It secretes which juice? It secretes saliva. That contains the enzyme salivary amylase. Salivary amylase works only on starch. To give what? To give maltose. And the medium is neutral and pH equal to 7 and the temperature is 37. While in the stomach, you hear some people, they have an acid in the stomach. So this is why we have gastric juice that is secreted by the gastric gland. So we have the enzyme pepsin that works on protein to give peptide. The medium is acidic. Here, these two are special. Only these two. Why? Because the medium, and the first one is a neutral in the mouth. That's why we have taste, the sour taste or the sweet taste. And in the stomach, the medium is acidic, while the rest, all of them, they are basic. You have to keep this in your mind. All the chemical medium, they are basic, unless two. In the mouth, it's a neutral, and in the stomach, it's what? It's acidic. And the rest, they are basic. And all you have to know, pancreas, secrete pancreatic juice that contains enzyme peptidase. From its name, peptidase, it works on peptides. To give what? To give amino acid. And the medium is basic. And the temperature, 37. Trypsin, it works on protein to give amino acid. Who can tell me which one is stronger? Pepsin or trypsin? And justify your answer. Let's see, which is stronger, the enzyme pepsin, which is this one, or the enzyme trypsin, which is stronger and can digest faster? Let's see, with justification for sure. Yes, Ghadi?
Is this trypsin?
Trypsin, why?
Because it's... Because in, you taught the amino acid.
Okay, it gives amino acid. What is the amino acid? Can you define the amino acid?
It's the simplest form for
protein. Very good. It's the simplest form. While pepsin digests protein into what?
Peptide.
So what is the peptide?
It's the complex form.
Peptide is the complex form?
Intermediate.
Intermediate form. So here, trypsin digests protein complex into simplest, while pepsin digests protein into intermediate. So here, digestion is going to be faster work in the case of trypsin. Thank you, Ghadi. Thank you. Maya, your question is, or you want to answer?
I wanted to answer the pepsin.
Okay, I'm going to give you a new question. So keep in touch, Maya. So here, I want you to know which test allow us to identify, Maya, the presence of reducing sugar.
The iodine test.
Reducing sugar.
Oh, reducing sugar.
So what do we call the test that allow the identification of reducing sugar?
Test?
Yes, Maya? Okay, let's move to Laya Bustani. What do you think? What is the name of the test that allows the identification of reducing sugar?
The feeling test.
Excellent, feeling test. What is the positive result, Yalaya?
The positive result is brick red.
Brick red precipitate. Very good. Thank you, Leia. So brick red precipitate. Wahal, if I want to ask you a question, Kareem. Good morning, Kareem. Do you hear me?
Yes, it says good morning.
Good morning. So if I told you, Kareem, give me a one test that allows us to identify the presence of peptides and give me the positive result.
Biorit test, yes, does.
Okay, what is the positive result of the biorit test?
Color?
Yes?
Violet color.
Violet color, very violet good. Color. So violet color allow us to positive result for the biorit test. Thank you, Kareem. Let's move now to Adam Tairi. Good morning, Adam.
Good morning, Ustaz.
If I ask you, Adam, what is the name of the test that allows us to identify if we still have starch or not?
Iodine.
Iodine test. What does it give? Which color positive result?
Dark blue.
Dark blue. Very good. So here, the iodine test help us to identify whether we have starch or not. If we did this, the result, if you have a piece of bread and we put with this piece of bread, saliva. Will digestion occur? Yes or no? Justify. Your answer, Ya Ali Hassan Basma. If we have piece of bread and we put it with the saliva, it contains which enzyme?
Saliva?
Yes.
Salivary amylase.
Salivary amylase. If you have a piece of bread is a starch.
Yes.
So saliva amylase, it works on starch or not?
Yes.
If we did the iodine test,
digestion will occur.
Digestion will occur. If we did the iodine test, it will give a positive or a negative after 1 hour, let's say.
Negative.
Negative. Why? Because the starch will disappear. And it will change into what? It will change into maltose. Okay. So the result will be a negative result. And there is a change in the color as well. Okay, thank you, Ali. Let's move now to new voices. I want to hear new voices. Celine Najdi, good morning. Celine Najdi, good morning. Okay, let's move to Gabrielle. Good morning, Gabrielle.
Good morning.
Okay, you hear me now? Celine Najdi.
Yes, it says.
Okay, let's finish with Celine and then we can go back to Gabrielle. Okay, Celine, if I ask you a question, if we have lipids, what give me the name of the test or the tests that allow us to identify the presence of lipids.
Peptidase test.
What is the name of the test or the test that allow us to identify the presence of lipids?
Lipids?
Yes.
Translucent?
Translucent spot test. And the second test is? Sodium test.
Yes, it's okay. The one with proteins. It's the sodium test.
I know, we're talking about lipids only. Okay. So it's the sodium test. Okay, great. Thank you. So here, let's move now to the Gabrielle. We have the enzyme trypsin, and we have an albumin. What's the meaning of albumin? Anyone knows what is the albumin? Albumin is the egg white. Okay, albumin. It's a protein. So this albumin was placed with the enzyme trypsin. Okay? And trypsin was placed with this albumin. Albumin, as I said, it's a type of protein, Gabrielle. So we gave them about 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, all the protein, all the albumin, they are transformed into amino acid.
Amino acid.
So we did the birate test. It gives positive or negative after 1 hour. We did the birate. It gives a positive or a negative?
A positive.
Positive? All the albumin were transformed into amino acid. So it's what? A positive or a negative?
Positive.
After 1 hour. We have only amino acid. Only amino acid. So there is no protein or nor polypeptide. So it will give what? We give a negative result.
Negative.
Okay, while at the beginning of the test, it will give a positive, sure. Okay? Okay, Gabriel, thank you. So here, everything is done. You have to study these notes. Please, this table is very important to study. Now we covered all of the table. We covered now 4 new enzymes. So till now, we have all of the enzymes. They are ready, and you have to study them. And this is everything for our session for this week, week 27.